never sleep at night after I watch this stuff.
And here's our first fight with Jason Stainthorpe of MMAC versus Bobby Attril. Straight right knocks down Bobby Attril.
You see him, I notice they have shin guards on. That's something I'm familiar with in Illinois and amateurs. Does that hinder your grappling at all?
You know what? They can get in the way. People train with them on all the time, you know. Even pros train with shin guards on all the time. So I don't really think it's going to be too big of an issue. Bobby Attril is working a very solid Muay Thai clinch. Jason Stainthorpe has heavy hands. He's throwing big right hands. Yep. Bobby's doing a lot of movement, very hard to time. Oh, goes right in for a double leg stop by Jason Stainthorpe.
And right into side control. Fire, man.
He's
on top.
He's got a headlock position. If I was Bobby, that's tried to lose a little more dominant position to him now, but, you know, he's going to throw some knees that did some damage on our body.
You're going after
him. If I was in Bobby Attril's corner, I'd tell him to stop hitting him with those kicks. He needs to set those kicks up with his hands, or he's going to be in big trouble because Jason's looking to land with his right hand. Jason's got power on both his hands, man. That left hook, right straight combination that Attril is dangerous. Looks like I got a little problem with Jason right there. He's got a little too much water on him. He's got to wipe him down. Seems to be all the biggest controversy in the U.S. right now. Is people getting greased and everything like that.
Slippery opponents.
Yeah.
Bolton, nice.
Another straight right.
Bobby
keeps leaving him with his head. He's got a talk, stop this one.
He just let him get back up. Just let him get back up. This kid does not stop. He is coming forward.
Nice sprawl by Jason. I'd love to set up that right hand again. Bobby's wide open that middle. Another left hook, another left.
Man, he's got a chin.
Man, Bobby's tough, man. He's working that clinch.
There he goes. Nice Jason.
Oh. Jason jabbing out of the clinch.
He brings it back out of the center.
Right by Jason. Single leg attempt by Bobby. He's got to set those shots up a lot better. Jason's starting to get into his takedown.
Superman punch attempt.
Bobby needs to slow down and set up his attack. He's jumping in. He's setting himself up to get hurt.
You think he's got a little desperation, Sam? You think he might be thinking he's down a couple rounds and he's just going after it?
I think he might think he's down on the scorecards. I mean, I guess I'd have to score in Jason's favor right now. But, Another right hook lands flush on the temple of Bobby. True throw by Jason. Beautiful throw. Bobby is visibly tired.
Yeah.
He's expelling a lot of energy with that, with the movement he's doing. Right hook by Bobby. Lands the body of Jason.
There's no quit in that kid, man.
Not at all. Bobby is tough. Jason's super tough, too, man. Great fight.
This is great.
He's working the clinch now. Dominant position on the head. Bobby just works dominant position on the head. This throw that means he's not going to get any power right here. Especially
nice,
with his back against the cage.
Jason's leaning on him. That's gonna put some pressure on him. Gonna tire him out a little bit, make him carry his weight.
10 seconds, man. These guys are in great fight, man. Start off this show, man. Really great fight.
Nice stuff. Show mutual respect there. That's why I love this sport. You can beat each other up. For 9 or 15 minutes, you hug and it's all over, and you walk away and you learn from it.
That's a great sign of respect right there. Jason's corner just walked over and beat Bobby Porter and raised his hand. That's a great sign of respect. You know, it's really great. These mixed martial arts, you know, coming to the martial arts and pulling out respect for the martial arts. We're seeing no lack of respect in our
community. Absolutely not.
That was a very, very exciting fight. If you were to score this fight, what favor are you going to?
I'm going to probably have to go with Jason. I might give him one round to Bobby. He was so aggressive. I think the second round I would probably give it to Bobby, just for his mere aggression.
I'll tell you what, man. Hats off to both fighters. At least I've heard step in this ring. Bobby, very a push of peace. And, you know, coming from American Taekwondo, from Baltimore, man, he really pushed the peace. And, you know, but I'm going to have to say Jason did more damage and controlled the fight more on the ground. So if Bobby was going to touch the scorecard, I'm scoring this fight for Jason right now.
I'm not wanting to be a judge, that's for sure.
I'll tell you what, they call him Jason Nonstop Sleeper. He came all the way from Scarborough, Ontario, Canada. Here in Newtown today, man. So,
he's a gamer, he's hungry.
That wasn't exactly taking a bus ride here. But great fight by both of them.
I'm anxious for the decision.
Now, Nathan, we got a very, very exciting fight coming up next. We got Jim O'Hare. A wrestler versus Matthew Perez, another wrestler from Team Chamber. Two great fighters in the 165-pound division. I'm very much looking forward to this fight.
So we got two wrestlers. Are they going to mitigate the wrestling and stand and bang, you think?
Yeah, I think so. And I've watched Jim O'Hare fight before. He's an Amarillo guy. I actually grew up with him, and he shows up to fight, man. He's a wrestler, but he's looking to land some power before he goes in for those takedowns.
Pennsylvania guys love to bang, man. I don't know. waiting for the judges to get their scores.
Nah, I'll tell you what, man. The Hometown Athletic Club, we're watching on Real Fight Live, this place is a very nice facility, and they are putting on a great show. Man. The American Mixed Martial Arts Fight Team is going to be, I feel, a powerhouse in the local shows. They're really putting on a great show.
Oh, yeah.
They really care about the fighters here, man.
Yeah, we got some great support from the Army. It's always nice to see the soldiers out. I know that I spoke to a couple of them and thanked them for their service. It's nice to see the Army behind these kind of events, getting behind local events, and being able to talk to the soldiers and express my gratitude for what they do and letting us live in this country.
As a fighter, I think I sacrifice a lot going into the ring, but I think about the servicemen and women out there who really put their lives on the line and sacrifice so much so we can have simple freedoms like this. Really hats off to them. And, I have a brother who's a Marine and another brother who's in the Air Force, and I really look up to those guys. Have the utmost respect for anyone out there serving this country.
Right. I have a cousin as well in the military. He's 19 years old. He was in Afghanistan. I remember when I was 19, I was worried about my next test and studying in the library. This kid's in war. It's amazing,
Ladies and gentlemen, the scores. Judge number one, 27 out of 30. Judge number two, 30 to 27. Judge number three, 30 to 27. The winner by unanimous decision out of the blue corner, Jason Stainthorpe.
That was a great fight. Both those fighters left it all out of the line right there, man. Nothing to feel bad.
I like to see this respect. And that's why you're an amateur. You're getting your experience. You're getting tested, put in waters you haven't been in before. And I can't speak for it as I'm not a fighter. But Sam, you can tell me these amateur bouts are definitely.